Hello and welcome to my brand new Q&A video series about the Pandas library in Python. My name is Kevin Markham and I'm the founder of Data School. So here are the four things I'm going to cover in this video. Thing number one, who is this video series for? Number two, what is Pandas? Number three, how can you get Pandas? And number four, what should you expect from this video series? So, number one, who is this video series for? This series is for Python users who want to work with data and use a powerful and efficient tool for doing so, okay? So, you don't have to be an expert Python user to get a lot out of this series, but you do have to know some Python, and because I'm not going to be teaching you, I'm not going to be focusing on Python itself during this series. Now, you can be brand new to Pandas, okay? Or you can have some experience with Pandas and you just want to get better. Either way, this series is for you. All right, number two, what is Pandas? Well, in a sentence, it's an open source library in Python for data analysis, data manipulation, and data visualization. So all of those things were certainly possible in Python before Pandas existed. However, I'd say that it's no surprise that after Pandas came out, a lot more data people get excited about working with data in Python. That's because Pandas just makes it easier to work with data. And I'll tell you a few things I like about Pandas. It's got a ton of functionality. It's well supported by the community. Lots of people know Pandas and want to share that knowledge. It's under active development. It's got a lot of documentation. And it plays well with other packages. So for instance, it's built on top of NumPy for numerical Python, numerical computing. And it also works well with scikit-learn for machine learning. So I use Pandas, I teach Pandas, and I think it's a worthwhile tool to learn if you work with data in Python. So, number three, how do you get Pandas? Well, if you just do a Google search for Pandas installation, you'll be taken to this page, and this page shows you lots of different options, but it's gonna say that the easiest way to get Pandas is by downloading the Anaconda distribution of Python, which includes Pandas and a lot of other tools, including all of the Pandas dependencies. So that's what I recommend. The Anaconda distribution is what I use, so it's an easy way to get up and running, but you can install Pandas however you like, all right? And finally, number four, what should you expect from this video series? So first, every video is gonna start with a question, and I'm gonna try to answer that question, all right? So I'm gonna be writing code live, writing it on screen, and explaining what I'm doing and why I'm doing it, and giving you different options to accomplish the same objective. Every video will use a real data set so that, and it's gonna be hosted online. That way, you can get the experience with working with actual data in Pandas without having to make up data or to download stuff. You're actually just gonna be able to access the data set by URL and follow along exactly with everything I'm doing on screen. Okay. Every video will also end with a bonus tip related to what we just went over. All the code I'm writing will be in the IPython notebook, also known as the Jupyter notebook. However, you don't need to use the IPython notebook. You can use whatever Python environment you are comfortable with. However, if you want to use the IPython notebook, it does come with the Anaconda distribution. And I've got a video that I'll link to below that explains how to how the basics of using the IPython notebook so that you're not completely lost at first. All right. My plan is to release a new video every Tuesday and Thursday. Videos will be about 5 to 10 minutes. And I'm going to start with questions that my real past students have asked me about pandas. But then I'm going to move on to making videos that the community is asking me, that you're asking me in the YouTube comments. So let's get that started right now. If you have a question about pandas right now, just go ahead and put it in the comments below. And if you already know some pandas, go ahead and share your favorite resource in the comments that helped you to learn pandas, and just help out your fellow students by sharing those resources with each other. Okay? So that's all for now. I appreciate you joining me. Feel free to click subscribe if you want to keep up with this series. And then I will see you again soon.